On this site, on April 30th, 1789, George Washington was sworn in as the first president of the United States of America. After he took his oath of office, a 15-cannon salute was fired from the East River. It came from the Galveston, a Spanish warship, the only foreign ship in the harbor at the time. If just a few years earlier, New Yorkers had heard cannons being fired from a warship in the New York Harbor, they would have been scared. They would have assumed they were at war. That it was a Spanish ship would not have been very comforting. The Spanish were longtime enemies of the British, and Americans were taught to be suspicious of Hispanics. But now, after the Revolution, Diego de Gardoqui, the Spanish ambassador to the United States, was an honored guest of George Washington at the inauguration. Later that night, Gardoqui lit up the Spanish embassy in celebration. It was at that embassy in a mansion at the foot of Broadway where Gardoqui hosted the first Catholic masses of the new capital, something that would have been illegal under the British. But now, after the Revolution, New York would get their first Catholic church, St. Peter's, funded by the King of Spain, Carlos III. So much had changed in such a short amount of time. How did Washington and the Americans come to embrace Gardoqui and the Spanish-speaking world? It all started with salted cod fish. 15 years before, in 1774, Diego de Gardoqui was a businessman based out of Bilbao, Spain. Salted codfish was popular in Spain at the time, and Gardoqui traded with salted cod merchants in Massachusetts. His American contacts wrote to him for muskets and pistols, and Gardoqui started to smuggle them arms. This was the start of Spain and France secretly arming the Americans, a very risky business, and it basically guaranteed that the Spanish and French would have to enter the American Revolution. And they did in 1779.
Diego de Gardoqui was always an unsung hero of the American Revolution. He was a Basque merchant, trained in Britain and had perfect command of English. He was the very first merchant to provide arms to the Americans, starting in 1774, even before the first shots were fired at Lexington and Concord. Now, this was very risky because the British could capture and impound his ships on smuggling charges. In 1777, he took control of the Spanish government's program to send large amounts of munitions, clothes, and supplies to the Americans.
Usually when you hear about the American Revolution, you hear about citizen soldiers, farmers who picked up their muskets and took on a world superpower, the British Empire, and won. It's a classic pull yourself up by your bootstraps American story, but it's not fully true. The Americans needed the help of immigrants and international allies. At the lowest point in the war, Alexander Hamilton wrote, "If we are saved, we will be saved by France and Spain." And they were.
The role of Spain in the Revolutionary War was critical. The United States could never have won the war without France, and France never would have fought the war without Spain. And that's because Spain and France were joined at the hip in the war against Britain, because only by combining their two navies could they overwhelm and defeat the Royal Navy, which was the most important asset of the British Empire. Now keep in mind that the real prizes were not the American colonies, but rather the very rich sugar colonies in the Caribbean and the promise of empire in India. So the entry of Spain made this a world war. And by helping to overextend the British, they assured American victory.
Spain was critical in the Americans winning the war in two ways. One, supplying the American forces. In the end, over 90% of the muskets and bullets and cannons that the Americans used came from the French and the Spanish. And much of it was smuggled through the Caribbean and Spanish-controlled Louisiana. The other way the Spanish helped was in actual fighting. Over 100,000 Spanish and Latino soldiers and sailors participated in the war. I know you're thinking when you learned about the battles of Lexington and Concord that you didn't hear any Spanish-sounding names involved, But what few people realize is that the American Revolution was also fought in other parts of North America, the Caribbean, Central America, the Mediterranean, and even in South Asia. And participating in many of these battles were soldiers and sailors from Spain, Cuba, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, Venezuela, Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras, and Nicaragua.
The spring of 1780, they took the Battle of Pensacola, which is perhaps the great Spanish victory against British troops in the American South. And those battles were, in a sense, drew British troops away from the Northeast, therefore helping General Washington win the battle up in that sector of the Revolution.
The Spanish-speaking world made great sacrifices for the American Revolution. Over 3,200 Spanish and Latino sailors and soldiers died fighting. Between Spain and France, they contributed the equivalent of $30 billion to the war. If you stack that in $100 bills, that would be taller than 70 Empire State buildings. Spain might have gotten involved in the American Revolution because of their rivalry with the British. As the saying goes, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. But on Inauguration Day, 1789, George Washington and Diego de Gardoqui marched down Broadway side by side. The U.S., the Spanish-speaking world, stood together.